another evangelist's byproducts of her actions. Although this time, she didn't intend for this one. The reverberation ensemble either distorted or even more distorted than ever. And the rest of us about to clear up the mess. Philip can't catch a break, can he? He's been beaten down 3 times so far. As for Eileen, she's misguided. I believe I know who her father was. And believe me, he had what was coming to him. Greta? She's a psycho, even by the standards of the back streets of District 23. And she was probably quite monstrous looking when she was human. The musicians of Bremen. They turned into some kind of skeletal hydra. I can't think of any other way of describing it. Anyway. Time for the Red Mist herself to take care of this one. And it appeared that each gave the other something. For example, Philip, he gave the others burn immunity. Eileen gave him smoke immunity, which she gave herself. And to the others. Greta protected the others. As for the musicians of Bremen, they gave something completely random. But beneficial. Well, what was certain was that it would help if the language team used some smoke of their own. I can see a theme around these distortions. Philip was driven and seen by the constant defeats of the library, the loss of those that he apparently cared about. Eileen was driven insane by the loss of her father due to me killing him. The musicians of Bremen were driven insane by the, well, pianist. As for Greta, she was driven insane by the pursuit of the ultimate fleet. Well, probably due to it. Right now, it doesn't matter either way. What does matter, however, was that they wanted to finish what they came here to do. And that was distort as much as they could to bring their insanity to pretty much everyone. Couldn't let that happen. And it looked like Gevura's team, she was focusing on Eileen first. I didn't know why she was focusing on her first, but it wasn't up to me. I had my own problems. Oh yeah, and that'll be explained eventually, just not right now. Right now, it's the lower floors, members of the Reverberation Ensemble. And hard to know who's taking more of a beat. It was nothing that the Red Mist couldn't handle. Especially not with her gone split signature move. Something that Retta wouldn't see the funny side. Oh yeah. As for the problem of Retta being shirtless, I don't think it really matters. Well, compared to a life-threatening situation. That and she was part fish. Yeah. Not easy to prioritize the right things. Especially with a contract in effect. Yeah. Channeling the ancient art of slice them up and make them feel the burn. And with Eileen incapacitated, it was time for Yabura to get a little more predatory. Yeah, and there was still the problem of how to deal with it. Well, with whatever could be spared. Well, thankfully, there was one that wasn't the focal point of aggression. The rest, well, they just need to do what they could with what they had. Although I was thinking, why haven't certain individuals come here? I mean, with all the attention that was being attracted, it'd only be a matter of time, right? Then I remembered that there were not only in the shadows, but they were also patient. And with Eileen gone, the others were weak. and the power of each eel was available. And with two of them close to being shaken up, it was as good a time as any to use it. The power of the Mountain of Smiling Bodies. Yeah, Gabura decided to focus on the more pressing matter. Well, couldn't hurt to be more defensive. And yeah, I know, everything's a lot more colorful around here. I mean, it's not to Angela. I mean, considering what else we'll be dealing with. This is a Myla case. I mean, have you read the descriptions of the others? Christopher was the first. Although there was the hope that with the EGO of the Red Mist, there was still hope to defeat our enemy. Yeah, Gabura wisely decided to get rid of Greta next. Largely because she was protected. The others, well, they had their own targets. And Mary didn't have a lot to work with. None of them did. Not many remain, although Philip was incapacitated, and Greta just turned into a Japanese daughter. All that remained was the musicians of Bremen. And it ain't looking good for them. Let's face it, they were gonna lose. A lot quicker than I thought. Next, we have the six-handed Oswald, who brought some chaos into this mix. Not just the ability to summon his circus, as for Tanya, well, certainly hasn't gotten any weaker. I'll say that much. As for who to send against them this time, well, I decided that Malkuth would be the best option. Yeah, Jaehyun, he delivered strings that sped everything up, as it made everyone faster. I could summon something nasty to those that died with the strings. At least, that was the impression I got. but I also got the impression that it wouldn't do much good if they were dead. It was also hard to tell what to send against what. But Malkuth somehow came up with an idea. She wasn't sure of what to send against them. Well, they needed to be taken out. We also needed a dose of reality. That we wouldn't just dance to their tune. In fact, they'll be doing a different kind of dance by the time we're done here. Yeah, not the best outcome, but it was still early days. And at least some of them would be able to hit harder. Oh yeah, the return of Mr. Knife and Miss Mermaid. I mean, how much longer must they do this? I mean, didn't they take enough of the beating from Tepereth? And we know what kind of a beating she can get. Yeah. There are all kinds of mad in this library.
Well, Oswald, he was clearly content to leave his performers to do his dirty work while he hid away. Oh yeah, the strings could also be used against J.U. Because they could be cut. And if they were cut, it'd end badly for him. Opening him up for attack. As for what the others were doing, Beaver countered. These distortions we're doing, or they focused on causing as much damage as possible. Oswald has one advantage in this case, is he's not the only freak around here. As for his other performers, they're not as strong as he is, so they can be incapacitated much more easily. And what fortunate timing. Aurora has something that would help her out greatly. Although it would also help if she focused on the right target. One that was slower than her. Malkuth was hoping that things would be better than it was with the language team. Yeah. Gibber is held in reserve in case of failure of one of the other teams. Well, there was hope that it wouldn't come to that. That's not exactly going to help, is it? Not unless something more direct is done. The stakes were higher than ever. And everyone knew it. Let's see. Oswald, he just wanted to entertain people. He just had a twisted way of doing so. The puppeteer, he just wanted to bring his son back in a less than healthy way. I put a stop to that. That might have been a mistake on my part. As for the head loop, she was likely a thug before she distorted. Not the best example of humanity, even in this city. And that is saying a lot. Oh yeah, and by this point Oswald decided to make a return appearance. Clearly he was getting bored. It was a matter of who would die first. Well, it wasn't gonna be Tanya. But she was certainly capable of taking it. So it would either be Jayan or Oswald. It wasn't something that they were making it easy for us. As they weren't just gonna let us take him down. Thankfully, Malkuth was supporting those that needed it. Unfortunately, there was only so much support that she could give. Well, thankfully for Aurora, she had something that would allow her to at least have a chance of causing damage. Well, she certainly withstood the chaotic nature of Oswald's main method of attack. And Oswald was certainly taking a big enough beat, as was Jaehyun. And this was going beyond simple vengeance. This was about stopping the Reverberation Ensemble from becoming worse threats in the city. Unfortunately, there wasn't enough to go around as far as what to use against each of them. Thankfully, Malkuth could help with that. Well, there was the hope that it would be enough. But like so many things in the city, we could only hope. Noel was focusing on the w- while both he and Melhoof were focusing on Oswald. Yeah. Amadeus was not a good sheep. It was only a matter of time before he was down. Unfortunately, Null went down before Amadeus did. Yeah, time to up this piece of oak tree. It was only a matter of time before they were taken down. Especially with the fourth match fleeing. Well, the red strings would benefit Aurora greatly, because the faster she moves, the harder she'd hit. Yeah, the others were taking quite a beating. Tanya, on the other hand, was not. Well, the other two were not as, how can I put it, durable as she was. Yeah, Rose, she decided to use both ETO. And a good thing too. As the return of Mr. Knife and Miss Mermaid. Only make things harder. and I knew who was after this. And believe me, they were gonna give in. Even harder time than this. Well, at least by this point, the puppeteer had just had his drinks cut. Probably asking, where's Oswald? Well, I know what was coming next. Where's Mercy? There wasn't gonna be any. As for Rose, one that had fun doing this, she decided to focus all her attention on the puppeteer. All that was left was Tanya. Oh yeah, and Oswald was not in good shape either. Due to the loss of Jaehyun and the rest of his performance. Yeah, Rose knew better than to bet Tanya. Caused damage to Malkuth. Well, especially as it was looking like burning probably, well, that killed Tanya before. Physical blows. The history team was looking pretty beaten up. The power of each you was one thing that could save everyone. At the very least, make sure that Oswald was unable to finish off any others. Besides, they might still be needing my father at the time. And defeating Jayan provided strings that provided an additional beatdown. Well, an increased capacity for that. Much as defeating Tanya did something similar. That was the end of them. The library was standing up against a vampire, a demon, and a lunatic. Yeah, the odds seem heavy, but we'll begin to that.